Since the boating season is about to start any minute now, it would make sense to focus on the question everyone have asked themselves at some point. How to tune up two-stroke outboard engine? It is simple. Take one of these and turn it to one of these. Well, obviously it isn't that easy, but you get the idea. Welcome to this new video series that will focus on modifying the Yamaha 40 two-cylinder two-stroke outboard engine. The engine code of the specific engine is 6E900. The main goal of the modifications is, of course, to get more power out from it. The engine is planned to be installed on a very lightweight speedboat. So the low RPM torque is not so relevant as it would be if the engine was installed in a, for example, a fishing boat. So let's get right into it by first having a brief history of the project and then introducing the current situation of the project. Now, if the history wasn't your favorite subject in school, or you don't want to see how the expansion chamber exhaust system is installed in an outboard engine, you can skip right to the test start section. I fabricated this boat back in 2015 with the help of a couple of my friends. The first engine this boat had was a 4-cylinder, 2-stroke, blue ribbon Mercury 50. It went really good speeds with the engine just drop on the boat and with no further adjustments. The max speed with the Mercury in the right weather conditions was around 46 knots. However, I felt it was lacking maneuverability. My friend had similar boat than mine was, and he was able to do tight 180 degree turns even at full speed. He had a lighter outboard engine than Mercury was. So in 2018 I bought a 1982-ish Yamaha 40 outboard engine for it. The maneuverability of the boat increased significantly and I too was able to make sharp turns. It was so much fun. However, even though the maximum speed was pretty much the same as it was with the Mercury, I needed more. By coincidence, my friend has just started to experiment of having expansion chambers on outboard engine. The project he had was originally a 9.9 horsepower Tohatsu, and he was aiming for getting 27 horsepower out from it with around 12,000 RPM. Here is a short video clip of the test start of that project. Mind your ears. Now, I have always been a fan of two-stroke engines, and I have been tuning them since 2005. I made my first expansion chambers exhaust pipe back in 2008, and I have modified a piston port intake engine into a case reed valve engine back in 2010. So returning to my once beloved hobby sounded too good to be missed. I bought an spare parts Yamaha 40 outboard engine. It was just a power head. I measured all the dimensions in the engine and fit them into a motor engine simulation software. I also designed the new combustion chambers along with the expansion chambers. Furthermore, I modeled the engine in the SolidWorks to verify the design of the expansion chambers. I made some serious modifications for the engine block itself. I ported all the ports to new specifications, filled the original combustion chambers and machined the new shape in them, and of course, welded the original exhaust pathway to the lower outboard section shut and by welding and grinding turned the exhaust pores so that they exit through the exhaust cover to the side of the engine. After the modifications for the engine block itself were done, I could start to fabricate the expansion chambers. Although I could have had the pieces cut with the laser, I decided to cut them from the sheet metal by myself. After all, that was something I used to enjoy. And what an enjoyable little afternoon it was. After 6 hours of cutting the pieces, I was left with the pipe section pieces and a pile of wasted sheet metal. With the pieces cut, I could start to roll and weld them. I used only an anvil and pieces of different sized pipes to get the pipes rolled to the desired shape. After welding the pieces and making the new exhaust cover, I could start to assemble the engine. The engine got new reed valve pedals made from carbon fiber and a new head gasket made from aluminium. And after all the necessary fabricating, it was time for the test start. The test start was a success. Although you can see on the video that the engine misfires a couple of times. At the time I thought it was because there was raining and the typical Finnish summer weather. So maybe the CDI and coils are getting water inside them. After the test start, we take the engine and the boat into the lake to see how it performs in the water. The test ended up quickly because there was water coming out of the tailpipe of the exhaust. What a glorious moment it was to get the boat in the water after months of hard work. Just to pick it up almost immediately and receive a sarcastic applause from the opposite shore of the bay. It turned out that the engine block had cracked from the waterway into a transfer duct. The location was so hard to reach that the welding it was out of the question. I ended up grinding it the best I could and then cleaning it with the sodium hydroxide and casting the crack with the epoxy. That solved the problem, and yet again it was time for another test drive, this time on a more quiet location. At least it was quiet. Do note that this test was performed with the stock propeller. At the time we didn't have any surface propellers, so we had to use what we had. The engine did pull very strong, even at low RPM. In fact, it felt more stronger in every occasion than the stock did. So we got to test it a little bit, but we found out there is some sort of RPM limitation within the CDI, although there wasn't any specific circuit for it when we opened the CDI box. The peak power band starts at 5800 to 5900 RPM. The RPM limitation cuts the spark at 5750. so we never got it into a big power band. Also, it did blew a head gasket. And as I feel myself lucky, it blew it so it blocked the waterway to the engine head. And the piston started to melt. The Mark water spray was spraying all the time as it takes the water just before the head gasket. After blowing the head gasket, I make the new one out of copper and fortify the section that failed. And of course get a new piston for it. The maximum designed RPM for the engine is 9000, which should be safe for a 600cc 85mm piston engine. The peak power should occur at 8500 and it should make roughly the double the power than the stock has. That concludes the history and the current state of the project. For anyone interested about the boat, here is one clip with the stock engine, but this time we have a surface blubber in it and also lift. It was filmed in September 2020. Thank you for watching and please let me know in the comment sections what you think about this kind of project. If you would like to have more videos like this one, please consider subscribing.